What does it mean to be the salt of the earth? Jesus said that we have to be the salt and light. When Jesus talks about the salt and light, I guess most of you understand the meaning of light. If we somehow huddle inside our own faith and do not share it with others, it is useless. When you hold up a candle, you can use the flame to light another candle and light up a whole room. But why salt? Really? In Matthew 5:13, you are the salt of the earth, but if the salt loses its saltiness, how can it be made salty again? It is no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A town built on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on a stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. First of all, the human body can't live without sodium. That's biology 101. Sodium is essential for nerve and muscles function. It plays a role in the body's control of blood pressure and volume as well. Salt used to be used as currency, valued like gold. It can also be a preservative. Salt kept things fresh before refrigeration. It is not only crucial to human life, but also Christian's life. Christians are to be an extension of Jesus Christ. Jesus died for our sin and rose again so that our sins are forgiven and might have eternal life. In Acts 4:12, salvation is found in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given to mankind by which we must be saved. Without Christ, eternal life in God's kingdom is not possible. To be the salt of the earth is to deliver this message to the rest of the world. Jesus is so creative. Throughout his ministry, he used parables, analogies, and metaphoric depictions to emphasize his message. I always stress that we are creative too. You know why? It's because we are made in the image of God. In this analogy, if salt loses its saltiness, then it is no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. The analogy is that when Christians were losing their saltiness, that is, if you do not repent, your heart will become hardened. We Christians are called to change things in the world and point the way to Jesus. We can impact the world for Christ in amazing ways when we follow Him. In Colossians 4:6, Paul wrote that, "Let your conversation be always full of grace, seasoned with salt, so that you may know how to answer anyone." Is your speech seasoned with salt? Mind your words. Your words should express tolerance, thankfulness, and kindness. Finding other people's fault is easy, but extending grace to others is not. We should express tolerance rather than judgment. Another interesting thing about salt is that salt will make you thirsty. Thinking about eating a salty ramen or some potato chips, you need water. Who is the living water? As the salt of the earth, we are able to make people thirsty for Jesus. We are thirsty. Jesus comes to us in our thirst. We are going to close this session with Psalm chapter 63, verse 1. This is a psalm of David, and he was in the desert of Judah. As in Psalm 63:1, "You God are my God. Earnestly I seek you. I thirst for you. My whole being longs for you in a dry and parched land where there's no water." Seek first the kingdom of God, and all these things will be added to you.